So this is Rat Jeff from Maximum Threshold, Santa Ana, California. And joining me right now is
Jason. Hey,
man. Yo, how are you doing, sir? Thank you for joining me, man.
No
hey,
problem.
Man. Obviously, you've been drumming with the folks with Jeff. So tell me, man, how's that whole vibe going, man? And how long, for those that don't know, how long have you been in the band, by the way? I know, it's
a year as of today. Actually. And someone remembered.
Yeah.
Our one guitar player's girlfriend was nice enough to remember that.
Right on, man. And those that I know, and they should know, Shadows Fall, right, man? I'm sorry, man. Forgive me, man. I don't...
Everybody asks, what's going on?
Yeah, it's going on. It's a cliche question, bro. I gotta ask.
Anthrax has a new album coming out. That's what's going on. That's where John is.
So you don't want to elaborate on that or anything, man?
There's nothing to elaborate on. Okay. I mean, right now, seriously, we're not done. We never said that we were done. We just said we're going on a hiatus.
Yeah, but you know the rumors.
Everybody's just got so much shit going on.
Yeah.
When John joined Anthrax, that was the first thing that made one of the wheels come off the bus, kind of. You know, because he's an irreplaceable member. He's one of our founding members. He's always one of the core songwriters in the band. He needs to be there. I mean, yeah, we have Felipe filling in on the road and whatnot, which was great too, because he's a great player. But as far as it's for the band, when we first started with Paul going out and staying home with his kid, we're already down one guy. And then now, if John's gone, now there's two guys are down. So, like, the band becomes a revolving cast.
I know, man. It's like I said, you hear shit on the social media and all that crap. That's why I like to go to the horse's mouth.
Right.
Because of the horse's mouth, man. Well,
right now, what's going on, John's has a record coming out with him.
He's got it.
I'm going to have a record coming out with Flotsam. Matt just put out After Defiance. Mm-hmm. So, there's three guys from Shadows Fall that are in touring bands right now. Now, we're still trying to do whatever we can do. We actually just did like a couple hiatus shows a few months ago on the East Coast. But now, we just had an offer for the Philippines in April as well. But we can't take it because Brian's expecting his second hit.
Okay.
And it's like right at that time frame because all of us were like, oh, John was free, I was free. Like, well, yeah, we can do this show. And Brian's like, no, got a baby on the way. Like, all right, maybe next year. So it's still there.
Yeah.
We're still writing material too.
That's good, man. That's
John, me, John, and Matt, and Felipe, who was filling in for John before, the four of us are writing material together. Matt's playing bass.
Okay.
So we don't know if it's going to... We're just jamming.
Obviously, we don't know if it's going to happen.
We don't know if it's going to end up being a Shadow Small thing.
Yeah.
We don't know if it's going to be a different band with a different singer. But the three of us, the four dudes, are still doing something
else. Right on. Let's get back to Flotsam. All right. So right now, you guys are just on tour. You guys, now what's going on with the tour as regards to you're just doing, you're just concentrating on the West Coast? Or are you going to hit the East Coast and all that? Or have you already done that?
Well, what came about with this? We actually did 6 days on the East Coast back in July before we went to Europe again. So
New York, I can believe, right?
Yeah.
New York, yeah.
New York, Connecticut, Massachusetts. There was three New York days in Rhode Island.
Sorry, being
rude.
Rock and roll.
Exactly. Three New York dates, a Massachusetts date, and a Connecticut date.
Okay.
So then we went off to Europe again for the second time. For this...
Anybody else?
For this, what happened is we got off from the two Death Angel Christmas shows.
Yeah.
So we took the two shows and then we just wrapped some stuff in between. So, you know, while Michael flew out from Sacramento, I flew out from New York to go to Phoenix to do this, let's, you know, make the most of it. So five shows later, we go home for Christmas, finish the record. We have to deliver the record by the 1st of January, or at least for mixing.
So there is a new record in the works, basically.
Almost finished. Late May, early June.
Very good. There you go. Drop it. Check it out. Obviously, they can get all that stuff on social media sites and all that good stuff. So what else is going on? I mean, you're involved in a lot of projects. Why not just sites?
Yeah. We don't try to stay busy just for busy's sake, and I like playing. Yeah, I mean, and that's the thing too. So if I'm not,
you gotta help Michael with his trannies too.
Exactly. Michael knows about his
trannies. Anybody else?
So anyway, I watch open the door. know, lessons, clinics, stuff like that. I've got another project. I've got another project going with some friends. It's called Midnight Whiskey Worship.
Okay.
And that sounds
cool.
This is me. This is me and Ed, who was our fill-in bass player in Shadows Fall a few years back.
Okay.
It's a 15-minute interview, I think.
Yeah.
It's me and Ed and Frank Arrested from Face Warning.
Oh, shit!
Yeah.
Wow.
And our friends, it started out as a project with three Berkeley guys. Me, Ed, and our guitar player, Steve. So then we wrote Frank into it because me, Ed, and Frank used to do a band called Dark Days Sunday. So we wrote Frank into this with us. And then we have a singer that we found out in Jersey named Bronco. He's just amazing.
Yeah, you're Berkeley boy, right? Are you a Berkeley boy?
Yeah, I was there for two semesters and I left to get out. Like everybody did.
Yeah.
You know, we have such a small graduating class, but people go there, they meet people, and they take off, and they tour.
They get on the bands and stuff, man. Especially MI guys, I mean, all that, man. I mean, could it be safe to say, would you rather have, today's musicians go and do something like that, or just go and learn out there in the field? Because I've talked to musicians, I like the jury,
I think, personally, it depends on what you want to do. When I went there, I was going for music education, so I was going for a 5-year plan that would have set me to be a band director. That's really not what I wanted to do with my life. So, as I said, I went there, I learned core stuff, I learned other stuff, music, and I was able to branch out and go play with people. I think if you're going nowadays, the business is so different 30 years later, 25 years later from when I was in school. If you're going, go for music production engineering. Go for music business. Go for something that's going to actually maybe make you a dollar. If you're going to learn how to be a player, you can take lessons and learn how to be a player on your own. Berkeley or MI or any of these music schools are great, but they're not going to teach you how to be a touring musician.
Exactly.
You have to get out of here and do this.
Exactly.
You got to go to school or not.
So basically, you get the experience, you should get the experience, knowledge, like you got the interning, I find myself interning with different music, engineering, whatever, man. I want to learn it. So what can they get you on your social media sites? The boss out of
We have the Fossil page, Fossil Facebook page, Fossil website, www.fossil-and-jetson.com.
This is going to be a great interview.
Yeah,
by the way.
It'll be all subtitled.
This is going to be the best interview in the world.
It'll be all subtitled.
We're going to have trannies coming in pretty soon, too.
Just so they don't get an idea that I am into that.
Last time I saw this guy was at NAMM, and the East Coast, he was getting a shout out for the East Coast guys, Maxwell Dressel on the East Coast, and mentioned something about a little tranny, man.
I don't even remember how it started. We did an interview in 2012 with Dom and Mike.
Yeah.
And I roped in Mikey, who was our fill-in bass player at the time. I said, hey, you wanna actually feel like you're a band member and do an interview with us? And he's like, sure, because I know what to expect with Dom and Mikey. I knew it wasn't going to be a regular interview.
No.
So I was like, yeah, let's do this with Mikey.
You have my interview, and then you have their interview.
So we roped Mikey T in, and all of a sudden, it became a thing where it started with a few serious questions, and then Michael Strong was just like, boom, so do you like trannies or what? Just out of nowhere. Yeah. And it just became
I can't use that material, man. I gotta use my own material.
The look on our bass player's face was priceless, and he's a
stickler,
team player.
He's business.
He went along with the joke. He thought it was funny. But it was one of those never-ending jokes, still on Facebook between me, Michael, Mike, and Tate. Hey, dude, how the trannies doing?
So what you guys is next up, man, and we'll get out of here, man. What's next up for you guys?
Vegas tomorrow, then we go home.
That's it?
Yep.
Done?
Get the record done and get out for spring, hopefully.
Right on, man. Thanks, man. Thanks for taking time out, man.
Thanks,
appreciate it, man.
Again.
Yeah, man. Thanks, man. Hey, this is Brad Chef from Maximum Threshold. Check these guys out, man. Go to their websites. Go to their social media sites, man. Check them out. What's up?
New record. Hey. Hey, what's up? This is Jason Bender from Flotsam and Jetsam in Chapel's Fall, and you're listening to Maximum Threshold, West Coast.